this is, you know, we're in the middle of our season, things are going well, but this is what it's all about when you're in a position that I'm in, is this is more important than what's taking place under the lights, for 7 innings, or a ball game, or anything, or compete for anything. This is really what it's about when it comes down to it, is having one of your players have an opportunity to continue playing a game when you started at 5, or whatever it was, you enjoyed so much that you want to do it to at least the age of 22. So, going to the next level, Tyler will be the 24th player in my 11 years here that'll have the opportunity to continue their playing career to the next level in college. Very excited for that. He's the third in this senior class that will go. Watching Tyler's maturation process, and I know y'all hate it when I say that, but there is no more truer player that I've watched go through this maturation process than Tyler, in my opinion. He comes to me, you know, it's a 5-year process. He comes to us, I saw the potential in 8th grade. I knew it was there. I knew what he's accomplishing now. I really did know it was going to happen 5 years, 4 years ago. I knew it. I told Scott that. When we talked on the side, I told Tyler that. There was times when I looked in Tyler's eyes and it was shell-shocked in his freshman year, maybe a little bit in sophomore year. Maybe didn't have the confidence that I wanted him to have, but it was just a building block and stepping stones, and it kept going. Here's what I mean by that, is I didn't feel when he was younger, he thought his stuff was good enough all the time to get out. I thought it was. And so he tried to be a pitcher than he was freshman year, 12 innings pitch, 16 walks. Sophomore year, maturation process, 50 innings pitch, 35 walks. Junior year, 50 innings pitch, 25 walks. Senior year, 29 innings pitch so far this year, 12 walks. ERA has gone down tremendously each and every year, stepping stone. Nothing more evident than this quote, not by me, this is by his future coach at CBU, Coach Parks. The night they decided that CBU was going to be his home for college, Coach Park put a tweet out there. It says, hashtag fire the cannons. Buck Nation, big time strike thrower, says he wants to be a Buck.
Hey, we're here with Tyler Flynn of Tipton-Rosemark Academy Rebels, getting ready to head out to Christian Brothers. Today's your signing day. How does it feel?
Feels good. It's been a long time coming. I've worked really hard for this. Been on many different teams to try to get recruited and seen for colleges. So
yeah, people out there know you from Bartlett all the way up to Covington and everything. So you've been around. When did you know you had the ability to possibly go to the college level?
So I've been doing these recruiting and showcase teams ever since I was about 12 years old. So ever since there, I've had a dream to play, but it really came to reality my sophomore year here at Tipton-Rosemark. I started building up strength and velo, and so then's when I knew I could do it.
And you're on a great team, and you had a couple teammates who you signed earlier. And being a part of that group, what kind of culture is here at TRA? Because the last few years, there's been quite a few kids signed.
Yes, sir. So we want to make a legacy this year, and that's what Coach Smith's always talked about. Just what do you want to leave as your legacy? And we want to make a big impact on this school and on this program to make a legacy.
You're definitely making a big impact because you're one of the guys who trusts on District 9. He gives you the ball. How does it feel to have that responsibility?
It feels very, very humble and good to know that a coach trusts you that much. You'd be the one or the two in the rotation.
Not overwhelmed.
No, sir.
And you've been doing well. You and Corey have been doing well. And you're off to a great start this season. What is it going to take for you to help your team get back to state? Because I know y'all want to have one trip up there before your career's over.
Well, so pitching's what's made us successful this year. I'm 4-0 and Corey's 4-1. So between us, we've held it down.
Now, another thing about holding it down, people do take notes, and the guys at Christian are taking notes. They had a couple Rebels over there already. They seem to like this program over here. How does it feel that you added your 9 to that list? Is it a good fit for you?
Yes, sir. I think it's a good fit because guys like Gil Irwin, he's up there. I played with him when I was a freshman. He's a great ball player, so I just like to step in and become like Gil Irwin someday, I guess.
Now, with separation from other guys, what's your best pitch? What's your mentality out there?
Well, so I'm not an overpowering pitcher. I'm not high 90s or mid 90s or anything like that. I like to get a feel for all my pitches. I believe my changeup is my best pitch.
Okay. Now, looking at you, you're not the big brooding guy. So I get the pitch in that Greg Maddux category of intelligent pitcher. Is that true?
I believe so, because Corey can get up there and just pump fastballs and just blow past them, but I'm more of a three-pitch batter kind of guy.
You're methodical with it. Exactly. Cerebral with it. Well, I guess the bad thing is you do add your name to the legacy of this baseball program today with this sign. And like I told my parents, you were a guy that didn't get all the headlines, but kind of went up under the hood, but you kept going. What kept persevering all the time?
Just Coach Smith just pushing me to know that I could do it, and just that's what really got me going.
When they said that's the test of true character, what you do, nobody's looking. And look where you are today, here today. How does that feel?
It feels awesome knowing that I didn't get all the recognition, but I still got some, and some is plenty out for me.
Well, we're proud of you here at the Memphis Chicks. Congratulations on getting out to CBU.
Thank you.
Congratulations.